What's up, family? It's your girl, Miss Lowe, and you're tuning in to Get Into It, Conveying Your Truth, here on LoveRadioNetwork.com. And tonight, we're going to talk about something that will literally knock your socks off, right? So grab your cup of hot tea, because this show is definitely going to be a cold one.
We've been making do it for a night, only one night, though. We've been making do it for a night, only one night, though. Cry, man, do it for a night.
So, family, are any of you out there surviving being left? I know you like, Miss Lowe, what type of question is that today? Well, actually, it's a great question. You know, the word left in this topic is very broad. You can be left by a parent. You can be left by a spouse. You can be left in foster care. You can even be left at the altar. Left out of a position at work. Even left by the ministry at church. Wow. But family, how are you? How are you surviving being left? And how is it affecting you now? See, many of us don't realize that we stay in certain situations in our now due to the fear of our past situations, right? Our fear of not being wanted. Have you guys ever heard of something called attachment disorder? Well, neither did I at first, until one of my children was diagnosed with it, right? So I couldn't just accept the doctor saying, I'm going to diagnose your child with such and such without me investigating and doing my homework, right? I have always been a person that I want to look up and see the definition of things. I want to make sure you're telling me the right thing, right? So it stated that children who have pain, abuse, and neglect can often impair their ability to develop healthy emotional attachments to people. But what if I suggested that we all suffer from a past-like child self, right? We are unable to perform properly now in relationships because of that. And we feel like we are always being left out of something because of our past truth. Come on now. We about to convey some stuff, right? What if we actually learn to deal with it? What if we actually learn to bring our past truth into our now truth? So, what you saying, Ms. Lowe? We got to be able to handle people now. We got to be able to handle people now. We got to be able to confront the people in the past. We got to be able to confront situations in the past. Yes, we definitely got to be able to confront it. Because when life hits us, when those jobs go to better candidates, or maybe when you did not become deacon, or when you did not become elder, you know, when you get overlooked, you got to be able to handle it. All these things are emotions. They come from our past truth, right? So, you know, when we deal with so many emotions as a child, right? I know some of y'all are like, oh my God, he should go again with this past. Yes, everything that happens in the past affects your now. Everything, right? So some of y'all out there saying, Miss Lowe, I don't have time for this. I don't want to combine nothing. I don't want to bring nothing from the past into the now. Well, you got to. If you want to move forward, you definitely got to confront your past, right? You want to be able to combine everybody from your past and everything from your past, everybody that left you, every situation that left you. You want to combine it into your now, right? So I want you guys to break free, to be able to break free, to be able to let go of every attachment in your lives that is causing you pain. You know, when a parent dies, we feel so empty inside. Especially if there are unanswered questions, you know. You end up being like Miss Lowe here. You end up being like, Ma, why you leave and ain't tell me who my daddy was, right? That's deep, right? How many of y'all didn't get a chance to ask your mom or your dad, where's my parent or who is my parent, right? What if you was adopted? What if you was adopted and you don't know where to begin? You didn't know where to look at. You don't know nothing. And you have these siblings that saying, nanny, 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 you adopted, you ain't my real sister or brother. Like, how does that make you feel? Right? To not belong. So parents can literally leave you so emotionally broken with so many unanswered questions. That's a tough one for me, right? Because I've dealt with that, right? So as a child, I was told I have hair like John, or I walk like this guy. I was so confused, and to the point I'm like, well, who is him and where is he at? Because I'm emotionally broke. I have went through so much trauma in my life. Where is he at? Why he didn't come save me? That's what I'm thinking, right? So I'm a mess messed up. I don't know about y'all, but I want to be set free. I'm going to continuously be set free on my journey because I am conveying my truth. I was emotionally a wreck. I didn't know if I was coming or going. I knew that I did not look like my siblings. We all cute. Right, but I had beautiful hair. I always say I had gray hair. But it was a curse and a good thing, if that makes sense to y'all, right? And I'm gonna explain it to you later. you definitely gotta stay tuned to the next show, because the next show is deep, right? So I ain't gonna give you a spoiler. I'll wait for you guys. Just be patient. But the next show, we're gonna talk about this hair thing. But anyway. So, you definitely got to get the book to figure out if I found out who my daddy is or not. It's called The Evolution of It. It is due to come out May 29, 2024, which is my mother's birthday, right? So, definitely go check out my book. But back to being left, right? What if your spouse leaves you? What if he up and leave? He done found somebody younger than you, somebody thicker than you. What if he divorced you? You definitely left feeling like you wasn't good enough. Or what did you do? Or what could you have did better, right? We're going to talk about that too, right? What do you do when you've done everything right, right? Or this right here hits home as well. What do you do when your child gets taken away from you and put into the system? Because the parents are definitely gonna feel like they lost a part of them. See, it's different when a child gets taken from you. I know for me, me and my baby sister, we both got taken from my mother, but by her being a baby, that was a different kind of pain my mother felt, right? Even though I came back at a certain age, it wasn't that same love. Like, it was different, right? So a parent can feel so lost, so empty when a child is taken. They can feel horrible when they lose a baby to death. Like, oh my God, have your way. Like, what I'm trying to get you guys to see, like, there's so many different situations that you can be left in from. You know, people can leave, and it will do something to your spirit, to your man, to your soul, and it will leave you emotionally broken unless you get help for it. And we're going to talk about it, family. We're going to talk about it. I'm going to help you, or try to help you, deal with your past truth. I'm going to try to help you bring it into your now, right? And that's what helped me. I had to learn how to convey my truth. I had to learn how to tell the truth and shame the devil. That's my thing. I'm going to stick with it, right? So, first we got to put some Bible and some faith behind us, right? We got to get some Bible principles going on here. So, in Psalms 147:3, it says, "He heals the brokenhearted and binds up their wounds." That's saying that God will heal your broken heart and cover your wounds up. Yes, he is going to heal your broken heart. When that man leaves you or that woman leaves you and you feel like you cannot go on with life, I'm going to need you to turn to this scripture. Jesus said that God will heal your brokenhearted. All them scars and wounds that you got from being abandoned, abused, neglected, and adopted, God will bind them up. Hey, come on, God. He said he'll bind them up. He'll cover them up for you. He said he got you no matter what. Trust him. Trust him in the midst of the storm, right? You got to trust the process in order to get to where you need to be. You got to go through some things in order to use it as a testimony to be able to bless somebody, God. To be able to help somebody get to where they need to be in life, right? You got to be able to use your testimony. So we're going to talk about this, right? Okay, so in Psalms 147, 13, he says he will strengthen the bars, okay, the bars of your gates. He blesses your children within you. So we're going to talk about this. So if we know that God will strengthen us, and then he'll bless our children to come. He said, I'm gonna strengthen you right now in the midst of your storm, right? I'm gonna strengthen you right now. So when you have a child, when you bear a child, or if you have a child right now, right? I'm strengthening you for them. I'm strengthening you for your inner child. So in order for you to be great for your children that you have at this present moment, we gotta help the child that was broken back then. What you say, God? He said, I gotta help the child that was broken back then. I'ma need this child that is now an adult to bring back. God has a way of tying everything together. I thank him, God. I thank him. Because as I'm teaching, I'm learning. So I thank you guys. I completely thank you guys. So let's keep going. He's saying that the past inner child that was left cannot carry on to the children that you have now, right? That's what God said. He said that we need to break free of being fearful of being left. That's right. That's right. We need to break free from being fearful of being left. That whoever shall leave, let them go. Because we need to be present right now in our children's lives. And we're going to talk later in our shows to come of why we need to be present in our children's lives. Right? We're going to talk about it. So the second tool is, we can't replace our past fear of being left. We can't replace it, but we will try, right? Let's talk about it. We're going to convey our truth, right? One thing about this show is that I love telling the truth and shaming the devil, right? I'm very honest. I love y'all feedback. I love the things that you guys are asking me and saying, but we're going to be real. We try to replace our hurt with some things, right? These things is people that don't mean us no good. We trying to replace other people with people that is worse than the people we trying to replace them with. We trying to replace them with drugs. I'ma smoke this blunt. I'ma pop this pill because it's gonna make me numb. I'ma do whatever kind of drug it is for me not to feel pain. Then I'ma go sleep with Harry. I'ma go sleep with Tom. Cause see, I have issues of my daddy being gone. I have issues that I don't want to deal with. So I'ma just be numb to this situation and I'ma just deal with who I deal with, when I want to deal with and how I want to deal with them, right? And just et cetera. It's different ways that we try to replace our past situations, our past pain. We do a lot of different things, right? I'ma set myself free. Since y'all ain't speaking to me, I'ma set myself free. So my thing was, I used to like to fight. I was a fighter. I didn't care about nobody. I did whatever I need to do. That's when I was younger. Now when I get older, I started doing different things. And you gotta get the book. Come on, quit trying to get me to tell y'all the book. The book is called The Evolution of It. It is dropping May 29, 2024. Get it. Pre-order it. Get the book. But anyway, so listen. Where was I at? Okay, so we have to be able to face it. Face the truth, right? Face the things that left us. We had to be able to fight it. How are we fighting it? We are going to, first, we're going to put some Bible principle on it. We're going to get some faith going here. That's one of the things, right? And then we got to accept it. We got to convey it, right? We got to bring it to the light. This is what happened, right? You left me, but I'm still here. I'm hurt, but I'm still here. You understand me? I am broken, but I'm still here. So let me tell you, God said I am healed by his blood, right? That washes me. You left me, but I'm okay. I may bend, but I'm not gonna break. right? So you know what, guys? I tell people this story, right? I especially told people this story in 2023. Because life was life, and right? And people was asking me, like, no, how you get through such and such? This is my story, right? So, you know, one of my favorite stories in the Bible is when Jesus was on a boat with the disciples. So, I may not say it right, but if you Bible readers out there, you know what I'm talking about, right? So, and if you don't, just, I mean, hey, if people don't know the Bible, I used to Google Siri or whoever, where the disciples at on the boat with Jesus, and it's gonna come up, the whole scripture is gonna pop up, trust me, right? So anyway, we having fun, right? We learning, we having fun, and we talking about God. Couldn't be no more better than that. So Jesus on the boat with these disciples, and he trying to get some sleep or whatever, and a storm come. Now these disciples, they scared, they afraid, they worried about drowning. And even though the boat is leaning and rocking and it's tilting a little bit, Jesus said, just be still. You know, we all right. We still on the boat, but we have not sank. That's what he is saying to us. Stay on the boat. You ain't sinking. Jesus wants you to have faith in him, even though people have left you. Come on, God. Even though jobs didn't see you. You understand me? Even though your heart is breaking, and you would have never left that situation if that person hadn't left you. But God said, I got you. Just stay on the boat, right? Just stay on the boat. I'ma be your life jacket, right? I'ma be that. You all right. Let me go over here and get some for nothing when I said, worry about nothing but pray about everything. That's what he said. But I'm reading Bible, y'all. I don't know if y'all reading, if y'all got y'all Bible, turn with me. No, I'm just saying, like, but that's what the Bible say, right? So the last thing that I want to tell y'all, the last tool, the important tool that helped me, I definitely believe that is going to help you, right? So I learned many years ago, I went to grief recovery 4 times at the Word Church in the city of Cleveland, Ohio, right? And grief recovery is supposed to teach you, or it teaches you, to deal with past grief, past truth, past relationships, past people that left you. Grief can be anything. Grief can be the loss of a dog, a cat, a wig, anything you're grieving about. Okay, back. So I went to grief recovery 4 times, and I was dealing with my husband and our issues. Then I had to deal with my mother and her issues. But I was angry. I was angry in these 4 times, and I kept going back, and I didn't know what God was up to. But he was up to something. Right, so I had no idea why I kept going back, but I kept going back, and I kept going to the same grief recovery counselor, Brother Cliff was not letting up on me, right? And when I say I was angry, I fought Brother Cliff. He gave me homework assignments, and these homework assignments would be deep. I would have to list past things. I would have to make vores. I would have to dissect some things. And I wasn't ready to do that. I didn't want to do any of that. I wasn't doing no projects, no homework, and I definitely was not in no group discussions. I was the most angriest, bitterness, but I was going to church. I was showing up to this group cuter than I could be. And one participating. I don't know what God was up to, but he said, you gonna get up and go to this group. I don't care if you sit there and look at people, you're gonna go, right? So anyway, I just was very rebellious, right? And then one day, Brother Cliff said, this was like a week before our graduation, he said, I need you to do something. I said, what you need me to do, Brother Cliff? Because everything you keep asking me, I ain't doing, because I'm just angry. You done opened up some doors. You done dissected me. You got me in here just acting up, and I don't want to do nothing you got for me. He said, I'm going to need you to write a letter. I'm going to need you to write a letter, a goodbye letter, to everything that hurt you in your past, to every person that left you, come on, God, in your past. I'm gonna need you to write a letter. And when you're done with the letter, expressing to them what they did, how they made you feel, I'm gonna need you to rip it up. Rip it up. Oh my God. When I say I wrote this letter and I was angry writing the letter, I was crying and snotting. I was so angry about this letter, I ripped it up when I was done. Like, I guess how I felt, like, you don't get no authority in my life no more. You don't get to molest me. You don't get to tell me I ain't nothing. You don't get to do X, Y, and D. You don't get to cheat on me. Oh, I was mad. I was writing letters to everybody in this one letter, right? And when I ripped it up, oh my God, how free was I, right? I had not cried near day in grief recovery, right? And when, let me tell y'all this before I finish the story, but in grief recovery and you're in a circle and we're discussing things, and if a person cries, like, there's a box of tissue in the middle. And the tissue is in the middle because you can't get up and hand that person a tissue, because it's like telling them to close your tears and don't bother it. Let it stay tucked away, right? Let it stay buried, because it's going to eat you alive. Just let it stay buried, right? So I was the one handing people tissue because I wanted them to be quiet. I didn't want to deal with nothing from the past. I was mad that they was dealing with it, right? But back to my story. So when I wrote this letter and I tore it up, I began to cry, thanking God that I was able to be set free, that I was no longer held in bondage. Thank you, God. Thank you for sending Brother Cliff to teach me this valuable lesson, right? I had to convey my truth. Come on, God. I had to bring my past into my now, right? So I did that and I was free. So during graduation, he told everybody he had this one student that he didn't think that was going to make it, but then she surprised them all. And what you know, family, that student was me. I showed up and showed out, and God did exactly what he set out to do. Set me free from my past. That's all he wants us to do, is be free and completely depend on him, family, right? See, God said it's okay. God said it's okay to tell things goodbye. He said it's okay to convey your truth and bring it from your past to your now. He said it's okay. I want you guys to just start conveying your truth. Even if you stand in the mirror and you start talking to yourself, convey your truth. Tell your mirror, because we talked about that too, the mirror. I'm sorry. Tell your mirror, this is my now, my past, and I'm bringing it into my now. What you want to do? You want to fight about it? But we gonna get it together, right? I want y'all to just start talking to yourself. Start telling yourself things that is keeping you in bondage. Start telling these people that affected your life, mentally, physically, you know, emotionally. Start telling these things. Call these things out, right? And I guarantee you, you will be set free. You will be able to cry more. You will be able to hug more. You will be able to love more, especially your children. Because you all know that past pain I'm a witness to that. It will affect your now with your children, right? But that was our show for today. I said a lot. We're going to keep digging into some things. We're going to keep conveying our truth, y'all. This is your girl, Miss Low, and I super thank you guys for joining and tuning in to LoveRadioNetwork.com here on Monday nights at 7:30. I look forward to seeing you guys next week at the same time, 7:30 p.m. Listen, family. If you have any questions, comments, concerns, email me at conveyingyourtruth2024@gmail.com. Let's get into it. Let's share some things, good or bad, happy or sad. Let's talk about it, right? I love you all. Be blessed, and I'll see you next week. We've been made to do it for a night. Only one night, though. We've been made to do it for a night. Only one night, though. Crying made to do it for a night. Only one night, though. Only one night though, only one night though. If you cry, you can cry one night. Only one night though. Stress, you can stress one night.